A very fresh morning to one and all present here. We are back with English subject. Myself Zainab Kagdi from Atmiya Green School, Jadeshwar, Bharuch. We are back with English subject, class 6th. So today we'll discuss about the PDF which I sent you yesterday in our group. It was of a lesson Marie Kom, Never Say Die, correct? So today we'll have a quick explanation of this PDF. Unit number 4, Playing Fair. I'll request you to take out your course book on page number 89 so that you can understand from the question asked in the textbook. We'll just discuss here its answers. Okay, so the first is on page number 89, reading 1. The question number 1 is, select the correct option to complete the following statements, correct? Now, the first question A is, I promised myself and I proved myself, says Marie Kom. How did she prove herself? So here there are four options. First, by playing and defeating man. Second, by being a successful and famous sportsperson. Third, by looking after her family and her career. And number four, by playing a sport that people thought was for man. So she proved herself and she promised herself what? The answer is by playing a sport that people thought was for man. So she promised herself to change this might and to prove herself. Right? So option four is the correct answer. Question two is, what were the two difficulties that Marie Kom faced? The answer to this question is being poor and diminutive. Diminutive means extremely or unusually small. So that were two difficulties. First was she was very poor, and second was she was very diminutive. Diminutive means very small. So for boxing and for such kind of sports, everybody thought that a person must be muscular and tall. Okay, now question number C is the third MCQ. What is Marie Kom's advice to women? Now its answer is number 3. It's her advice to all the women out here is to be more self-confident. Now question number 2 says, what are Marie Kom's most important achievements? What essential lessons has her journey taught her? So here we are having its answer. Marie Kom is a 6-time world amateur boxing champion and the only woman boxer to have won a medal in each one of the 7 world championships. She is the first Indian women boxer to get a gold medal in the Asian Games held in 2014 in Incheon. Perhaps her greatest achievement is showing the world that boxing is not just the man's domain and being an inspiration for millions of young people, both as a woman and a sportsperson. So here the question asked is, what are the most important achievement of Marie Kom? So here the answer to it is she is a 6-time world amateur boxing champion and the only women boxer who won the medal in the 7 world championships. That was her first achievement, and the biggest achievement was that she proved herself and she was even the first Indian women boxer to get a gold medal in the Asian Games held in 2014 in Incheon. Apart from that she also proved herself that this boxing is not just the man's domain, but women can even play this sport. And she inspired millions of young people, not only just women but all the sportsperson. So that is your answer number 2. Question number 3 says, I think we need to change our attitude towards the sports itself. Why does Marie think so? many things that we need to change the attitude to the sport itself, because the world nation lacks enthusiasm in promoting sports for both genders. While the authorities are making efforts and things are changing, she feels that compared to other countries, not as much is done to promote sports and support sportspersons. So, dear students, what does she answer here? That we need to change our attitude towards sports. For example, if a kid wants to become a cricketer, it is not always taken seriously. Like any sport person are not motivated. Matlab, everybody thinks, yaar, ye field mein kya hoga? You're not going to earn anything in this field. But we need to think and we need to respect person's passion towards sports. And we need to support as well as promote sport persons and sports itself. So that is your answer number 3. Let us move towards question number 4. What does Mary feel about excelling in a male-dominated field? That means, what does Mary feel about playing a game such as boxing, which is male-dominated? That is, only male used to participate in boxing. While participating in it, how do Mary felt? So the answer is, Mary Combe believes that her achievements will leave a mark on the society and help people to change their perspective that certain sports are not meant to be taken up by women. She believes that women can compete and win in any field of sports. So yes, here Mary feels that ki uski jo achievements hai, wahi ek mark chhodegi, that will leave a mark on the society. और वही लोगों के पर्सपेक्टिव्स वो चेंज करेगी कि विमेंस सिर्फ घर के काम करने के लिए नहीं होती, बट दे कैन ऑल्सो पार्टिसिपेट इन एनी फील्ड ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स. और वो बिलीव करती है ये कि कोई भी विमेन, अगर उसको कम्पीट करना है तो वो कम्पीट कर सकती है, एंड शी कैन इवन विन इन एनी फील्ड ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स. कोई भी स्पोर्ट्स ले लो, इट इज़ नॉट जस्ट कि वो मेल डोमिनेटेड है, बट कोई भी स्पोर्ट हो वो कोई भी जेंडर प्ले कर सकता है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 सेज, मैरी कॉम गॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन बॉक्सिंग. क्वेश्चन इज, व्हाट वाज मैरीज इंस्पिरेशन. सो वी ऑल नो दैट मैरी कॉम ने जो स्पोर्ट्स सिलेक्ट किया था वो मेल डोमिनेटेड था, करेक्ट? सो उसको इंस्पिरेशन के कहाँ से मिली? ओके, दैट इज़ द क्वेश्चन. Answer number 5, Mary Combe got interested in boxing when she was just 15 years old. She was first inspired by Dinko Singh. Please remember this name, Dinko Singh, the Indian boxer who won the gold medal in the 1998 Asian Games. Later, she was motivated to try harder and aim higher like her idol Muhammad Ali. Today, she is inspired by her own achievements and goals she has set for herself to win more medals for India. Her passion for boxing acts as the fuel that drives her towards her goals. So here we can understand that she got interested when she was 15 years old. Then two persons inspired her, that is Dinko Singh, who was an Indian boxer, and second was her idol Muhammad Ali. These two people inspired her. Today, she is inspired by her own achievements and goals she has set for herself to win more medals and make our country proud. That is what inspired her, and still now, this her desire is inspiring her to achieve more in her career. Question number 6 is, how did Mary train herself for the sport? So that is her training routine we read in our lesson. Answer 6 says, to train herself for the sport, Mary put in 8 hours of training every day, once in the morning, once in the evening. She also took great care of what she ate, following a diet that had food items from every group with the right balance of proteins, vitamins, carbohydrates, and other required minerals. She never deviated from the diet and ate at fixed times and never skipped meals. So this was how she trained herself for the sports. And now the last question is, what is Mary's advice to other Indian women? This is the most important question asked. So make sure you learn it by heart. Mary's advice to all Indian women is that if they are passionate about something, they should pursue it wholeheartedly. Even if people at first negate a woman's dreams, if she goes after her goal, she will succeed. And the people around her will eventually be proud and supportive of her achievements. She also advises women to be strong and more confident about themselves. So here she advises to all Indian women ki unko kuch bhi karna hai. If they are passionate about something, par unka koi passion hai. Bhale hi log unki mazak udaye. Bhale hi log usko negative vibes de. लोग उसकी अपोज करें बट इफ शी परस्यूज हर गोल देन शी विल सक्सीड एंड अदर पीपल अराउंड हर विल इवेंचुअली बी प्राउड एंड सपोर्टिव टू हर अचीवमेंट्स सो शी एडवाइसेज वीमेन टू बी स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड मोर कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट देमसेल्व्स शी नीड नॉट एनी अप्रूवल ऑफ वॉट शी लाइक्स फ्रॉम अदर्स इफ शी इज कॉन्फिडेंट about what she want to do and if she is strong enough to pursue it then she will definitely achieve her goals and people will automatically support her and be proud of her so that are all your questions from the course book now we'll move up to reading 2 that is on your page number 90 we are having two questions here the first is Mary had to face many hurdles to move towards achieving her dream to become a world champion in boxing. Elaborate. That is your first question. It says, Mary ko bahut sari hurdles face karni padi thi before she achieved her dream to become a world champion in boxing. Is cheez ko elaborate karo, explain karo. Kaun si mushkile, what kind of hurdles she had to face? So the answer to it is, The very first hurdle that Mary faced in moving towards her dreams of becoming a champion boxer was the extreme struggle with poverty, that means garibi ke karan, in her childhood. Due to this, the first difficulty and struggle was ki wo bahut garib ghar se thi, that means she belonged to very poor family. She suffered poverty. Poverty means jiske paas roti kapda makan nahi hota, education and health जितना होना चाहिए वो नहीं होता दैट पर्सन इज कॉल्ड पुअर और लिविंग इन पोवर्टी सो शी फेस्ड पोवर्टी इन चाइल्डहुड ड्यू टू दिस शी हैड टू हेल्प हर पेरेंट्स इन द फील्ड्स एंड टेक केयर ऑफ द हाउस एंड हर सिबलिंग्स इन एडिशन टू अटेंडिंग स्कूल सो वो स्कूल अटेंड करने के साथ साथ उसके भाई बहन देयर आर सिबलिंग्स और घर की देखभाल करना अलॉन्ग विद दैट शी हेल्प देयर हर पेरेंट्स It was not easy to fit in training. This was made worse by the fact that most people, including her parents, saw boxing as a male sport and discouraged her from pursuing it. उसके parents ने भी उसको support नहीं किया और वो भी वही सोचते थे that ये boxing एक male sport है that is it is always played by male participants. And secondly, her diminutive size was another big hurdle. मतलब diminutive मतलब extremely unusually small size. वो बहुत size में small थी उसकी वो भी एक बड़ी hurdle थी. Not only a woman but a small one at that, Mary had a hard time convincing people that she was made for the sport. After starting as a boxer, she found it difficult to balance her family duties with finding time for training. She also found it hard to afford the training and equipment that she needed. Even after she became famous in her sport, she got little recognition from the public and earned very little money. Despite having won 5 medals, it was only after she won an Olympic medal that things began to get easier for her. So, सबसे बड़ी मुश्किल दो थी सबसे पहली कि she was a female and so the first one was she lived in poverty वो बहुत poor थी तो उसको उसकी school और parents और siblings और घर सबको संभालना था और secondly she had a diminutive size that means वो बहुत छोटी थी in spite of being a woman सबसे पहला तो लड़कियाँ ये sports नहीं खेलती and secondly ऐसी लड़की जो बहुत छोटी है can not play such kind of sports and that made very hard for her to convince other people that by being a small one and being a female, she can also play sports. Okay, so even after winning 5 medals, it was only after she won the Olympic medal life became easier for her and everybody listened her story and appreciated her. So that is your question number, answer to the question number 1 of reading 2. Question 2 is, based on your reading about Marie Kondo, list the qualities that you think are required to be a successful sports person. Support your answer with examples. So that is your question 2 and your answer to it is, the question says ki aisi qualities bataiye jisse hame pata chale that kaisi qualities honi chahiye successful sports person, what are the qualities required to be a successful sports person, and you need to also give examples to support your answer. Okay, answer 2 is, encourage students to think creatively and formulate their own answers. Pointers, Mary displayed many characteristics that are essential for a sports person. A strong sense of self-belief, even when others thought she was too small and the sport was not for women. Determination in the face of opposition and an unsupportive family. Commitment to her goals. Number 3, number 4, persistence even when facing obstacles. Number 5, hard work and discipline, as she played with long hours of training and a strict diet. Next is passion and love for the sport, strength, courage, team spirit. In Mary's case, this is a desire to win medals for India. So there are many qualities here in order to encourage students to think creatively. So here, the answer to this question is, there are many qualities, but Mary displayed many characteristics. We can take the example of Mary and give support to this answer. First is strong sense of self-belief. Even though the world is opposing you and the world, your family and society are against you, you need to believe in yourself. That is called self-belief. So, wo hona chahiye agar successful sports person banna hai to. Second is determination to face the opposition and an unsupportive family. Agar kisi ke family support nahi karti, we lose morale and we lose our hopes. But ye determination hi tha uska jo usko aise opposition aur unsupportive family ko bhi usne bahut achhi tarah se samna kiya. Number 3 is commitment to the goals, persistence even when facing obstacles, hard work and discipline. ये सारी चीज़ें उसने कैसे डिस्प्ले की, फॉर आफ्टर डूइंग लॉन्ग आवर्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग, स्ट्रिक्ट डाइट, ये सब डिसिप्लिन बताता है. पैशन एंड लव फॉर द स्पोर्ट्स, स्ट्रेंथ, करेज, टीम स्पिरिट, ये सारी चीज़ें, दीज ऑल आर द क्वालिटीज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी अ सक्सेसफुल स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन. सो दैट वॉज योर रीडिंग 2. नाउ विल मूव अप टू वोकैबुलरी, पेज नंबर 90. ओके, योर sports idioms. Okay, here is a list of sports idioms. Match them to their meanings, then use them to complete the sentence. Now these idioms are such word where you find it in a short way which have particular meaning. Babko match A with B. Now you need to match the first one with the any alphabetical order on the right hand, correct? So first is take sides. What does take sides means? Now you need to explain this idiom, and the explanation part is, its meaning is written on the right hand side, that is in the column B. So the answer to is, take sides means defend someone. Number 2, get a second wind. That means have a burst of energy after tiring. Number 3, win hands down. That means win by a big margin. Number 4, go to bat for someone. That means support a person or group. Number 5, take the wind out of one's sails. That means deflate someone. Number 6, take the bull by the horns. That means accept the challenge and try your hardest. Number 7, start the ball rolling. That means begin something. Number 8, give it your best shot. Meaning try your hardest. So this is all the idioms and its meaning. It's wonderful and it's amazing. Now we'll move up to page number 91, where we are having certain fill in the blanks, where you have to use them to complete the sentence. So here the opponents had not practiced well. They could win hands down. Win hands down means, as it is in our number third one. Win hands down means win by a big margin. Correct? The opponents had not practiced well. We could win hands down. The sports captain wanted everyone to be seated so that they could start the ball rolling. Start the ball rolling means to begin something. Correct? Number 3, the coach took the wind out of her sails when he told her that unless she practiced diligently, she could not be a part of the sports team. Took the wind out of her sails will be the answer to it. Number 4, I will give it my best shot and make it to the finals. Give it to my best shot means try your hardest. Next is, I'm sure that coach would not take sides. He's just calling a spade a spade. That means he won't deflate someone. Number 6 is, even though getting to play nationals is tough, I think you must take the bull by the horns. Take the bull by the horns means accept the challenge and try your hardest. Number 7 is, the athletes were exhausted after a couple of laps, but they got a second win after the energy drink. She got a second win after the energy drink. Next is, Brain wants to join the swimming club. Mom doesn't like it, but I am going to go to bed for him. Okay, so that is your answer. Number 8, to go to bed for him. Now we'll move up to grammar part, that is tenses. Here we will study 3 tenses. First is simple present tense, simple past tense, and verbs showing future tense. Okay, so here we are having one paragraph where you need to find out, you need to read the passage, you need to spot the past, present and future tense, underline the words and then put them in an appropriate column that which tense it belongs to. So I'll read out that paragraph for you. The original Olympic Games included our competitions as well as athletics, boxing, wrestling and chariot racing. So your included is a past tense. The first modern games took place in 1896 and continue to take place every 4 years in different countries of the world. So your continue is simple present tense. The Olympics are the traditional world championships of athletics, but there are many other sport competitors, swimming, rowing, gymnastics and others. At each Olympics, the Olympic Committee includes, that is present tense, new sports, making each Olympics more exciting than the last. So here we are having 3 paragraphs. In that you need to find out and underline the verbs and then put it in an appropriate column, whether it belongs to present tense, past tense or future tense. If the talk is going on regarding the present situations, then it falls in the present tense. When we talk about past, then this ed included, ed, took, took, these are all past tense of the verbs, and the word will and shall are all belong to future tense. So this is the answer to that activity. नेक्स्ट एक्टिविटीज ऑन योर पेज नंबर 93, सिंपल प्रेजेंट एंड प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. ओके, सिंपल प्रेजेंट एंड प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. द वर्ब टेक्स प्लेस इन द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस इज इन द सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस. इफ इट टॉक्स अबाउट टुडे मीन्स फॉर प्रेजेंट देन इट इज कॉल्ड सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस. For example, my grandmother takes a walk every morning. Takes, when a verb plus s makes takes, so it is simple present. For present continuous tense, we use is am plus ing, verb plus ing. That is, my grandmother is taking a walk now. That means is plus verb take plus ing, taking. So is am are plus verb ing makes present continuous tense. So in present continuous tense, the form is or are plus verb plus ing. Okay, so now we'll move up to the exercise on page number 93. Fill in the blanks with the simple present tense or present continuous tense of the verbs given in brackets. Remember, there may be some exceptions to the rules given above. Okay. So here first one is, my mother often dash me to school in the morning on her way to work. In bracket we have drop. So we'll put S to drop, that means drops. My mother often drops. Number two is, we are trying hard, but this sum is really difficult to solve. So try will become are trying. That is present continuous tense. The form is or are. Here we used are plus verb, that is try plus ing. Number three is, the beautiful house where my grandparents live consists of 5 huge bedrooms. Consist is your answer number three. Number four is, my friend Parth is absent today because he has fever. In bracket we have, so have will turn into have. Sorry, yes, have will turn into has. Number five, I think I will go home right now. Think will remain think. Number six, the teacher has left the classroom, so the children are screaming. That is present continuous tense. Number seven is, Priya made Arun studies hard for the exams because she wants him to do well. Study will turn into studies. Okay, now on page number 93 we have one paragraph where we have to punctuate it. Punctuate the following passage on India's golden girl P.T. Usha. So here we are having one paragraph regarding P.T. Usha, so we just need to punctuate it. So I'll just read out the paragraph. So here we have the punctuation marks after if the name, the starting of the first letter of the name of a person, place always begins with capital letter. So it is Pilla Ulla Kandi Theke Parambil, that is P capital and T capital, in Usha U capital, is the most iconic women athletic of track and field, full stop. Now B capital, born to a poor family from a village named Payoli, P capital, it is the name of a village, so P capital, near Calicut, C capital, comma, Kerala, K capital, comma, she did not have a privileged childhood and faced many health issues and much poverty, full stop. I capital, it was only her incredible drive for athletics that got her the nickname of Payoli Express, P capital and E capital, full stop. A capital, at the early age of about 12 years, comma, Usha's U capital, apostrophe S, Usha's aptitude and passion for sports led her to secure a INR 250 scholarship from the Kerala state government, full stop. I capital, in the same year, comma, an athletics coach, comma, O capital, Nambiar, N capital, comma, noticed her, full stop. He at Capital was impressed with her and he began coaching her to stop. Next paragraph, Usha U Capital never looked back in her career. Full stop. She S Capital has won as many as 101 international medals till now. Full stop. However, at Capital, comma, her greatest disappointment has been the loss L Capital, Angels A Capital, Olympics O Capital, comma, where the Golden Girl missed the bronze by just 1/100 of a second. So this was all your exercise of the lesson Marie Kondo Never Say Die section 1 of unit 4 Playing Fair. I hope you'll complete your notebooks with beautiful handwriting. Thank you.